If you've chosen not to have hormone replacement therapy because you've heard that estrogen causes breast cancer, tune in today for an enlightening discussion with one of the world's leading researchers on separating fact from fiction. Hello, and thank you so much for tuning into Second Act TV. I am so excited to introduce you to Dr. James Simon today. By way of brief introduction, because Dr. Simon CV needs a whole segment all on its own, Dr. Simon is he is a clinical professor of reproductive endocrinology. Did I pronounce that right, Dr. Simon?
Endocrinology.
Okay, my first language is German. I'm sorry, I'm gonna blame it on that. And he is known to be among the world's leading researchers on women's health and hormone balance and hormone replacement therapy. He was also featured in one of my favorite documentaries, Hot Flash Havoc. So Dr. Simon, you are talking our language here today on Second Act TV. You know, this is a serious topic. And one of the things that attracted me to your message was that you want to debunk the information that's out there about hormone replacement and the cause of or risk of breast cancer. Tell us about that. How did that come about?
So the issue really is, do hormones after menopause cause breast cancer, cause breast cancers that are already there to grow more quickly, cause them to grow more slowly? And when we talk about hormones, are we talking about all hormones? Are we talking about specific hormones? Are there some that are worse, some that are better, et cetera? And when we lump rather than split, then we get into trouble. And that's what I believe the common understanding is. We got some messages that were very strong, very broadly distributed from the Women's Health Initiative study, a very, very important study, that were generalized rather than made specific enough that an individual woman can judge for herself.
So you really, what this study has done is a disservice to women, because I'm one of the people touting hormone replacement therapy on Second Act TV. Now, I specifically have talked to physicians and doctors about bioidentical hormone replacement versus synthetic. Does that factor into the study? Do you have an opinion on that?
Yeah, I think it does factor into the study, but not in the way that most people think. So first point is that estrogen or estrogens, whether synthetic or bioidentical, they don't cause breast cancer. Estrogens cause growth, and they cause growth of everything. Most of the growth that it causes, women like. It makes their hair grow, it makes their skin grow, it makes their bones grow. It helps the cells of the vagina to be healthy and lush and youthful. It makes them grow. But if estrogens make things grow, it also makes a pre-existing breast cancer grow. And so it didn't cause it, it just made it grow. That's the first thing. Now, separate from that is where the issue of bioidentical versus synthetic, I think, comes in. And there's a lot of research been done on bioidentical progesterone. We've been talking about estrogen, but about bioidentical progesterone and its absence of an effect on breast cells or breast cancer cells, whereas synthetic forms of progesterone do stimulate the growth and proliferation of both normal and cancer cells. And that's an important distinction.
It's a very important distinction. So if like myself, I have bioidentical estrogen, but I take the synthetic progesterone at night, so that's something that maybe myself and other women need to be aware of, that might not be a good idea?
Not a good idea.
Okay. So Dr. Simon, for the average woman who comes into your office, how would you assess the benefits and the risks of estrogen and breast cancer?
So I think that that's a very important question. And every woman needs to be considered individually. There is no average woman. There's no standard woman. Every woman is different. She comes with her own set of risks and benefits. For the average practitioner, and there may be not too many of those either, there are very well-established computerized programs that can help them understand whether that particular person sitting in front of them in their consultation is at low, average, high risk of breast cancer. And then they can make an individualized decision about whether she can, should benefit from hormone therapy, whether it's estrogen by itself or some combination of estrogen and progesterone.
So Dr. Simon, just kind of to sum this up to make sure that, you know, people like myself and our viewers understand it, estrogen therapy may actually reduce the risk of cancer and obviously improve our overall quality of life. I mean, what's the good news here? What's the takeaway on why we should be on estrogen?
So women who are at the biggest risk of having an adverse effect of menopause are women who've had hysterectomy. They do not need any progesterone, whether it's bioidentical or other. And in those women, estrogen reduces their risk of getting breast cancer.
Okay, interesting. Okay.
It doesn't increase it. It doesn't keep it the same. It actually reduces their risk. It's an important, undescribed, although it's in the scientific literature, but in, you know, if you ask your hairdresser, they never heard that. But it's true, and it's important, and we understand how that works. It's really important. And it was one of the silver linings in the Women's Health Initiative study, which was largely negative about hormones, except for a few things, this being one.
And, you know, that kind of what leads us into our next segment. Let's talk about the quality of life issues. You know, hormone replacement can do so much to make us feel better, to not go through this horrible time that, you know, of depression and hot flashes and ups and downs. And, you know, I love talking to you. I can see where people gravitate to you. I know that having a lot of the discussion that we're going to have is very uncomfortable for a lot of women, including their doctors. So let's talk about that as well and how we open up these topics and not be embarrassed to discuss them. We'll see you in just a couple of minutes. Thank you. Thanks so much for watching. Right here's another video I think you might enjoy. And while you're at it, please subscribe to our channel. Button's right here. Thanks. See you next time.